Unlike in previous Call of Duty games, in Cold War you're able to choose which weapons you want to get gold in order to unlock DM Ultra. So, rather than only having to do guns that came with the base game, as long as you meet the number of guns required for diamond in each class, for example you need to complete 5 assault rifles to get them diamond, then you can do whatever you want. Because of this flexibility in how you unlock DM Ultra, I figured it made sense for me to make this video about the easiest and best weapons to unlock gold on in order to unlock that beautiful Dark Matter skin efficiently. Throughout the video I will also have links to the various camo guides that I've made. These will appear in the top right corner of your screen at the appropriate time. So if you want an in-depth guide on how to get challenges done easily for a specific weapon or weapon class, then I would highly recommend checking them out. Anyway, let's jump into Cold War and talk DM Ultra. So first of all, I would just like to say that the weapons I choose as my recommendations are based on a combination of how strong and how fun a weapon is to use. I want to make sure you're using the best guns possible and having the most fun you can whilst doing this DM Ultra grind, because trust me, if you're not having fun, this grind is a real pain. So let's kick things off with the assault rifles. To be honest, I'm not going to go into massive detail about the pros and cons of every single weapon, because I mean, we would be here for absolutely ages. But where I feel like I need to give some reasoning or a bit of detail behind something, then I will absolutely talk you guys through it. Anyway, for the assault rifles, the ones that I would use to get the diamond camo unlocked would be the XM4, the AK-47, the Krig-6, the EM2, and the Farah 83. They are on the stronger end of the assault rifles, so like the M4 and the AK and the Krig and the EM2, they're all pretty solid meta weapons right now. And then the Farah, again, that's just another solid weapon. It's got a decent fire rate, decent damage, and you just can't go wrong. To be honest, assault rifles are just very easy to get diamond on. Just use them and you'll get it eventually. There's nothing specific you have to do. The only honorable mention I've got here is the Grozer, and that's because it's basically the only assault rifle that plays even slightly differently to any of the others. You can build it a bit more like an SMG. So if you want to mix up getting your assault rifles diamond, maybe throw in the Grozer in there. I'd replace probably the Farah 83. Play around with that, have some fun, and keep the grind fresh. Anyway, I think it's time we just move on to the SMGs. So the SMGs that I would use to unlock gold camo and therefore diamond camo for the SMGs, probably we'll go with in the strongest order, will be the Tech-9, the LT-10, the OTS-9, move up the list to the AK-74U and the MP5. These are 5 ridiculously strong SMGs. They are all so good. I would use any of them in a competitive environment if I was playing league play. They are all easily going to help you dominate your lobbies if you need to. So therefore, getting the camo challenges done on them is pretty simple. Again, it's a weapon class where there's not really any issues with getting them gold. I guess the most annoying camo challenge for the SMGs are the point blanks, and I've got a guide on that, don't worry. But ultimately, it's not the worst challenge of them all, and you'll probably get it done eventually just by playing anyway. So to be honest, not too much to say about the SMGs as well. Again, it's a really strong weapon class. It's really fun to do, and you will just get these challenges done as you play with the SMGs. I've got 2 honorable mentions for this weapon class, and these are the Milano 821 and the KSP-45. So we'll start with the KSP-45, and this gun is a burst fire SMG. It's pretty fun. It wasn't great when the game first came out. In fact, it was the first gun I got gold in Cold War. Back then, it really wasn't too good, but nowadays it's actually pretty strong and you can do well with it once you get used to it and you get used to the playstyle. So if you want to mix up your SMG grind, this burst SMG, the KSP-45, is great fun to use. And then the Milano, just this is a solid SMG. It's slightly different to other ones in that it's got a bit of a slower fire rate, but it's higher damage. So again, if you want to use an SMG that feels a bit different to the other ones, then this is a great one to use. I guess it's a bit similar to the Tech-9. Let's move on to the tactical rifles. I really wish I could get rid of these green dots. It's just so annoying on this game. I don't want to go through every single gun. I loved on Modern Warfare, there was just a button to get rid of them all. But anyway, let's stay on topic. The 3 tactical rifles that I would use to get the diamond camo unlocked would be the M16, the AUG, and the Carve 2. These are all burst tactical rifles. They're really good. They've got massive, massive damage potential. You can kill enemies in one burst, which means they have ridiculously quick time to kill. They are incredibly strong and pretty fun to use, to be fair. Like, I do enjoy a good old M16. Like, it's a classic gun. In terms of the camo challenges, the tactical rifles are very similar to the assault rifles. They're pretty easy challenges overall. You will get them done mostly by the time you've leveled the gun up, and then it'll just take a few more games to finish them off. In terms of the other guns in this class, the DMR and the Type 63, you absolutely can mix one of them in instead of one of the burst rifles if you want to mix your playstyle up again. Doing like 3 burst guns in a row would get a bit tedious, so if you want to do a semi-auto gun, I'd probably go for the Type 63. I don't know what it is about it. It's pretty much the exact same as the DMR, but I just preferred the Type 63 when I got it gold. Swiftly moving on, we'll head over to the LMGs. And in here, I would use just the three base ones, to be honest. The Stoner 63, the RPD, and the M60. They are pretty much the exact same gun, if I'm honest. You've got decent fire rate, massive damage, but really low mobility with these. I wasn't too sure how the LMGs would be when I went into doing them on my grind, but they were actually surprisingly fun and surprisingly strong. Once you get used to their incredibly low mobility, you'll have a great time because you just sit there, you become a human turret and destroy everyone you see. I really don't think the MG82 is that good in Cold War, so I wouldn't recommend getting it gold. But if you want to mix it up, absolutely go for it. These are just my recommendations based on my opinions. I guess that's LMGs covered, so we'll just move straight over to sniper rifles. We are absolutely smashing through this. For the sniper rifles, I am an absolute fiend for a bolt action gun. And I love quick scoping as well, so it's not going to take a genius to figure out which ones I would use. I would use the Pellington, the Tundra, and the Swiss K31. These are three incredibly good snipers. They're so much fun to use. I absolutely just love snipers. I wish there were more bolt action snipers to get gold, because there's just something about a bolt action sniper that just, well, it feels so good. Again, I've got a guide on how to get the sniper's diamond, and I've also got quick scoping guides for each of the bolt action snipers. So feel free to go check those out if you need any help with getting the challenges done, or if you need a class setup to go on your way with. The only real honorable mention I would give in this category is the M82. And this is just because it's a semi-auto sniper, so it's a bit different to the bolt actions. If you're not a massive fan of sniping, then the M82 might be for you, because you can kind of stay aiming down sights a lot longer and just click on enemies and kill them nice and easily. Whereas with the bolt action snipers, I found you needed a bit more of an aggressive playstyle to do well with them. So I would say start off with the bolt actions, and then if you're struggling and you just want to get snipers out of the way, then I'd end with the M82, because it'll probably be a nice gun to finish with. But personally, I would just do all three bolt actions because I love them. The ZRG is a pile of trash though. Don't go near that gun. Let's keep moving on and jump into the secondary category, where we will go for some pistols next. Again, we need to get three of these guns gold in order to unlock diamond on the pistols. So the three pistols I would choose to get gold are the AMP-63, the Diamati, and the Magnum. I am fully aware I don't have the AMP-63 unlocked, but I have used it plenty enough in Warzone and picking it up off the floor that I know this is a good gun, and I know it is better than, say, the 1911 or the Marshall. Whilst we're talking about the Marshall, I know that pistol is disgustingly overpowered, but it's only overpowered for basically getting one kill at a time, and it's not great at long ranges, so it's actually not that easy to get camo challenges done with it. Yes, it is OP in games, and especially in like Search and Destroy, but when you've got to get long shots and like the 5 kill streaks on it, it really can be quite hard. The only honorable mention I would give in the pistols is for the 1911, and that's basically because I know a lot of people don't enjoy the Magnum. Some people do find it quite hard to get gold with, and I do understand why. It's got a low magazine size and it shoots quite slow. You really have to be quite accurate with it. So if you know you don't like pistols, or you're not confident in your ability with them, I'd go for the 1911 over the Magnum. It's just a bit easier. I just found the Magnum really satisfying and fun to do, so that's why I picked it in this video. I think it's time we move on to the shotguns, and in here we've got to get two of them gold to get diamond, and the two that I would choose are the Gallo and the Street Sweeper. This is because, basically, the Hauer is absolute garbage. Just don't use that gun. It's so bad, and it is kind of hard to actually get the gold camo on it. So if you compare it to the Gallo, which is semi-automatic, or the Street Sweeper, which is fully automatic, it's just a no-brainer, really. Do the Gallo and the Street Sweeper. They are infinitely better than the Hauer. And that's basically what I've got to say on the shotguns. Onto the launchers here, you've got no choice in what you have to do. You have to get both the Sigma 2 and the RPG gold. It is the worst thing in the game, and I will not pretend it is easy by any stretch of the imagination. However, as you will probably have guessed, I do have a guide for how to get diamond launchers in the most efficient way, and a specific guide for getting the Sigma 2 gold. So if you watch any of my guides to help you along the way on your Dark Matter journey, then absolutely make sure you watch these, as they are so, so much harder than any other weapons in the game. And I don't want you to spend any longer on these than you absolutely have to. So because there's absolutely no choice here, we'll move straight onto the melee. Now, these come under the special category for weapon classes. So you have to get one melee gold and one special gold. So we'll start with the melees. And to be honest, I would do absolutely any melee weapon that you want to. Whatever you've got unlocked, whatever you think looks the coolest, just do that. They are all very slightly different in terms of mobility, attack speed. But the general way you would go about doing the camo challenges is exactly the same. So for that reason, just pick any melee weapon that you want. Whichever looks the coolest, just go with that. Personally, I would just go for the knife because it's simple and it looks pretty cool in my opinion. In terms of the specials, and we'll just hop over there, I would absolutely 100% get the R1 Shadowhunter Crossbow Gold. I had so much fun with this weapon and genuinely enjoyed doing all of the camo challenges for it. And that is just something you cannot ignore on such a long grind. If you have the opportunity to have fun at any point in this grind, absolutely take it. it. And of course, I've got a guide for how to get the R1 Shadowhunter crossbow gold. So feel free to check that one out if you want to see how the crossbow plays, or if you just want to get an idea for what the camo challenges are like on it. I'm going to say it right now, don't go near the M79, as that gun is just way harder than any of your other options in the specials category. The only reason anyone should be getting the M79 gold these days is if you enjoy being frustrated and having a terrible time. Trust me, just don't do it. As for the honorable mentions in this category, the nail gun is probably the one I would recommend, just because it is basically an SMG, just with incredibly low bullet velocity. So if you don't fancy the crossbow and you enjoy the SMG playstyle, then this is a great alternative for you, as it pretty much just plays like a normal weapon. And that is the end of the video already. We've covered every weapon class. We've covered every single gun that I'd get gold in order to get Dark Matter Ultra. I'd be really interested to know what weapons you guys would get gold. So if there's any that you disagree with, if there's any changes you would make, let me know in the comments. I'd love to see what you guys have to say about this. Also, if you want to see my entire Dark Matter unlock journey, then go check out my RNG Camo Mastery playlist. It's where I unlocked Dark Matter in a way no one else has ever done before. I had so much fun doing that series, and a lot of people seem to have enjoyed it. So feel free to check that out if you want. Again, link is up in the top right corner and in the description down below. I was thinking, as a follow-up to this video, and let me know if this is what you'd want to see, basically I'd make a video about the most efficient order of the weapon categories for DM Ultra. So while this video you've just watched was more focused on which weapons to do, I'd then be covering more of an overall strategy of which order I would do each class in. Let me know if that's something you'd want to see. I think it would be a good addition to this video, talking about the overall strategy for getting Dark Matter Ultra in the most efficient way possible. I think it'd be pretty interesting, but I want to hear from you guys. Thanks for clicking on this video, and thank you so much for watching it to this point. It means so much to me. By the time this video goes out, the Vanguard beta will have started, and I will have some content coming up for that. I'm absolutely hyped for it, and hopefully you guys are too. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you on the Vanguard beta.